Okie dokie. In this video, we're taking a look at using Next.js with GraphCMS. This video is available on the GraphCMS examples repo over on GitHub. I'm going to download it manually with npx digit. I'm going to paste that into my terminal, wait for it to download, then change directory into the project folder and open it with VS Code. Before we take a look at the project, I'm just going to yarn install the dependencies. While that's installing, we'll take a quick look around the project here. So we have a dynamic route here, which is getting a slug pass to it. We'll just go over the index page first here. We're using GraphQL request. We're hitting the GraphCMS e-commerce example project here. And we're using GraphQL request here to destructure products out of this query. So we're getting a product, slug, and name. That's returning products for the props here. And then in our page here, we're rendering out a Next.js link for a slug as the key, and we're going off to the products slug here. So this is our products and slug. Let's take a look at that now. So in here, we're using GraphQL request again. In the GraphQL client, we're defining our endpoint. Let's go down to get static paths here. So we're getting our product, slug, and name, and we're returning those in the params for the slug. That's been used in our get static props here. We're using the params.slug as part of our GraphQL request query here. We're passing in the slug as a parameter to get the name, description, and price. And then we're rendering that down here for the default of the page, product name, description, and price. Let's just quickly take a look at this in action. We'll do yarn dev, open up localhost 3000. And here we can see short sleeve T, the title, description, and price, short sleeve T, and the cap. Okay, that's it for this one. Hope you found it useful. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.